Hello and welcome to Pharmaceutical Analysis 2. In this video, we are going to discuss quantitative elemental analysis and the module is estimation of nitrogen. The learning objectives for this video are as follows. After viewing this video, you will be able to enumerate different methods for estimation of nitrogen. We'll be able to detail out Gilder's method for estimation of nitrogen and we'll be able to do calculations related to Gilder's method. There are two chief methods for estimation of nitrogen, Gilder's method and Dumas method. Gilder's method can be further divided into reactions, reaction with hydrochloric acid and reaction with boric acid. Gilder's method, reaction with hydrochloric acid. This must be carried out in sequence. And there are three steps in this particular case. The first one is nitrogenous organic compound is treated with concentrated sulfuric acid and we are going to get ammonium sulfate. In the second reaction, this ammonium sulfate, which is formed in the first reaction, is converted into ammonia gas by treatment with alkali. And in the third reaction, the ammonia which is evolved is being trapped in a trapping solution. Here we have taken HCl as a trapping solution and again it is going to form ammonium ion. The amount of the HCl taken here is in excess, so some amount will be left back and this left back amount will be estimated. With the help of the amount of the HCl obtained with the help of titration with the standard sodium hydroxide solution, we can estimate the amount of ammonia that has been consumed in this reaction. Now this is the apparatus which is used in Gilder's method. Here we are having sample, the organic compound which is present in H2SO4. It is being heated and we are going to get ammonium ion, ammonium sulfate. This ammonium sulfate is converted into free ammonia with the help of alkali. So when we are going to add alkali, the ammonia gas will evolve and it will pass through this condenser and it will go into this trapping solution. Already we have discussed this reaction with HCl, but in a single page we must discuss it once again. This is the first reaction, nitrogenous organic compound. It is treated with conc H2SO4 and we are going to get ammonium sulfate. Then this ammonium sulfate is reacted with sodium hydroxide solution to release ammonia. In this step, the ammonia is being released and this ammonia is then trapped in HCl, which is taken in excess, and we are going to get ammonium chloride and HCl will be left back. This left back HCl is then titrated with standard sodium hydroxide solution. Now let us take an example, then we will move to the calculation part. We have taken 50 ml of 0.1 normal HCl, that is in excess. So this is the HCl which we have taken and it is reacted with the ammonia which is being trapped in the solution. The volume of the ammonia reacted with HCl is unknown right now. We don't know how much amount has been reacted. So to know this particular amount, the difference, we are titrating it with 0.1 normal NaOH solution. Here we have taken 0.1 normal HCl, here we have taken 0.1 normal NaOH. So, let 20 ml of 0.1 normal NaOH is consumed by this HCl which is left back. So, from this equation, the equivalence, V ml of NaOH will be equivalent to V ml of NHCl. So, the amount of the NaOH consumed will be equal to the amount of the HCl which is present or left back in the reaction. So, therefore, 20 ml of HCl is left back in this flask. So, 50 minus 20 ml, that is 30 ml of HCl has reacted with ammonia. Now coming to the calculation, let the weight of the organic substance be x gram and V ml of NHCl is required for complete neutralization of ammonia evolved. Already we have seen this equivalence. Now 1000 ml of 1 normal ammonia contains 17 gram of ammonia or 14 gram of nitrogen. Here the normality is equal to molarity. Amount of nitrogen present in V ml of N ammonia will be equal to 14 by 1000 into V into N. And the percentage of nitrogen can be calculated by this particular reaction. Weight of the nitrogen, y gram, by weight of the safran, x gram, into 100, where N is the normality of the acid and V is the volume taken. Already we have discussed this particular equation. Now coming to the another reaction, reaction with boric acid. Here, ammonia gas, which is evolved from the first reaction, is being trapped in boric acid and it is going to form ammonium borate. The ammonium borate can be directly titrated with the standard acid using methyl redox indicator. So this particular reaction is going to have some advantages over the previous reaction. What are the advantages? Number one, it prevents loss of ammonia by volatilization. Second, the boric acid is too weak acid to interfere with further titration of ammonium borate. And the third point, there is no need of back titration as in case of the reaction with HCl. Since in case of HCl we have taken left back component, so another sort of titration, a blank, is also necessary. So in this particular case, there are advantages of taking boric acid over HCl. So I think so you have understood this particular thing. Now there is some assignment for you. Before coming to the class, please submit the assignment. The first one is enumerate different methods used for estimation of nitrogen in organic compound. What are the absorbent used in Gilda's method for nitrogen estimation? And write down the reaction occurring in Gilda's method for nitrogen estimation. I hope so you have enjoyed this video and I will look for your comments. Thank you very much.